Hello everyone, and welcome to the last Midnight Arrow devlog. This is the last devlog before I release the game. So today, we will look at the last level, do Fortnite dances, and also take a look at the things that maybe spent 3 years on this game. 3 years ago, when the game looked basically almost the same as how it looks now, I didn't expect it to take me this long to finish it. But there were a lot of things to be polished, mechanics to be added, and levels to be made. So keep in mind that making a finished product takes way longer than making a personal project. Now for me it is important that I am very close to releasing it, and I almost can't believe that I will finally have my first Steam game released. I once saw some advice on YouTube to release any small games that you make on itch.io, so you essentially get a confidence boost. Because once you have your first game released to the public, you are no longer a dreaming programmer, you are a game developer. I already released some projects on itch.io, but you can imagine the confidence boost that I will get after I release my game on Steam. Okay, so last time, I was working at the achievement system. Now I think that I managed to add all the in-game achievements that I wanted, including speedrun challenges. Achievements for collecting candies, being too bad at the game, touching some grass, and even a secret achievement that I will talk about later. Oh yeah, about speedrunning. The game is very speedrunnable, so I made the speedrun be part of the game. Inspired by an old Crash Bandicoot game that I used to play on my Game Boy when I was younger, once you complete a level, you have the option to pick up this clock and the timer appears. Keep in mind that the timer starts only after you pick it up, so you can in a way cheat with this system. But as with other similar things in this game, that is intentional. These are my times, without cheating too much. Feel free to beat me at my own game if you want to. Another important thing that I was working on was UI. I think that a bad UI can hurt the game a lot and make it look unprofessional. I'm still not 100% happy with how it looks right now, so I might still change some things about it. But all in all, it looks decent. I also added some sounds, made sure that it is responsive, and works well both with the keyboard and the controller. I also made it so that the game can detect your controller and display an appropriate UI for this. The process for this was kinda strange though. When you ask GLFW for the controller's name, all you get sometimes is something like wireless controller. So I can determine what brand it is with that information. What you can do, however, is get the controller's unique ID and look it into this big database of controllers. And by database, I mean this big text file. Then, once I find it, I look at its name and check for some keywords there, like Xbox or Xbox 360 or PS and so on. I kinda don't like this because the database has to be up to date and I can know if it is. For example, it doesn't detect my controller. I did my best however and it seems to work with the controllers that I tested, and I even checked the database for strange controllers like this one. So if you have that corner store controller, I guarantee that it will work, and added special UI for all types of controllers, thanks to this YouTuber that created this nice art for all controller types. And it is more important than you think to do this. PS5 controllers have different symbols than Xbox, but even worse, Nintendo controllers have the same buttons as an Xbox controller, but reversed. Yeah, I didn't even know that. I just happened to randomly find that out and I almost had them in the wrong order. Now I have special art for Xbox controller, for PS controllers, Nintendo, and even Stadia or Steam Deck. So if you're wondering what took me so long to release the game, it is things like this. This is basically the 80-20 rule that I want you to remember. Basically, it takes 20% of time to finish 80% of the game, but it takes 80% of time to finish the rest 20% of the game. And it is things like polishing the UI and adding nice features. Like, I did a nice squish and stretch to the character when it falls, or the camera shakes when it falls from a high altitude, the controller also rumbles. You also get feedback when standing on platforms that will fall, as you can see here, with an over-exaggerated effect. And the player also does this silly dance from time to time. I also wanted, however, to try to make it a Fortnite dance. If you think that I should leave the Fortnite dance in the game, smash like and share now. Now, what about the final level? I think I nailed the general vibe and the layout quite well. It is happening on a snowy mountain, and the particle effects Look very nice. Let me show you some gameplay. Now, since it is the last level, I needed something at the end, like a boss fight, to make the player feel like he really accomplished something great at the end of his journey. I won't tell you what I did because I don't want to spoil. Okay, just kidding. So I wanted something different than a boss fight. So I made this chase sequence where you run from a blizzard. Now it is time to talk about Burb. This is a character that originally was supposed to take part in the story of the game. Maybe you remember him from the first video about this game. Well, I changed the course of the game and removed him. But since I spent the time coding him, I couldn't just throw that code in the garbage. So Burb is back in the game, and if you find him, you'll get a secret achievement. Now I won't tell you where he is, even though it is quite obvious, but I will tell you that I made him extra difficult to find. Now, I mentioned that Burb was part of the story. Oh yeah, I have to add the story to the game. You see, for many games, the story is not something important, as it is in most Nintendo games. Usually, they are focused around gameplay and fun, and the story is just there, so there is one. I think that it is also the case for this game, but I still need a story. And since I wasn't able to come up with a story myself, I just asked a friend to help me. And to tell a story, I will use some drawings, as it is in Rain World. Yet again, I asked another friend to help me with this, and make the artwork. So now I just have to wait for it to be finished, because the code for this cinematic won't be that difficult to do. Now the story is simple. The main character has a little brother, and they live together. They are quite poor, so he takes a treasure map, and he leaves to find it. Yeah, very simple, but I think that it adds to the game that final touch that it really needed. And speaking of last minute things to be added, I'd also want to have an official soundtrack of the game. So for the level's music, I used some free music that I found online, but I would want to have my own soundtrack at least for the main menu of the game. So I paid a talented guy to help me, and it turned out very nice. Let me play you the result. Now the game will be released at the end of this month, and I am confident that it will go well. However, I would still need some more testing. So if you'd want to have the game for free, join my Discord server and tag me in the Midnight Arrow channel, because I am still planning to give away some more beta testing keys. It is a win-win for both of us, but the spots are limited, so the first people to ask me to join the beta testing will be the ones who will get the spots. Also, I'll of course have a discount when releasing the game, so go wishlist it, so you get notified when it is released to buy it on a discount. See you next time!